Could the former president of a billion-dollar healthcare company have possibly been responsible for creating the best barbecue franchise around? Bring some extra napkins, because we're ranking barbecue chains. Most barbecue chains get their start as small local restaurants, serving up their region's signature style of barbecue. That can't be said for Famous Dave's, however. Famous Dave's founder Dave Anderson grew up in Chicago. Even after spending 25 years searching for the nation's best barbecue, he wound up opening his first restaurant in a small resort he purchased on Big Round Lake in Hayward, Wisconsin. The restaurant was actually a barbecue shack, and the resort featured just 8 cabins. But the location was hugely popular, often serving as many as 1,000 diners a night.
I learned how important it is to have the right ingredients and that good food takes time.
Today, Famous Dave's has around 150 locations across the U.S., with locations in 32 states. Menus vary a little from one location to the next, but most serve a variety of types of barbecue, loosely inspired by regional specialties. In reality, their smoked and grilled meats, sides, pastas, and other dishes are more in line with standard chain restaurants than they are with a classic corner barbecue shack. Or, as one reviewer put it, if you've ever had real barbecue, you should never go to this place. Dickey's Barbecue Pit started as a single location in Dallas, Texas in 1941. Founder Travis Dickey served beef brisket and pit hams alongside 2 side options, barbecue beans and potato chips. 2 of Dickey's sons took over the family business in the late 1960s and quickly turned the restaurant into a chain, opening locations throughout Dallas and Fort Worth. In 1994, Dickey's Barbecue Pit began franchising, and in the 2000s, it went international. Today, Dickey's has more than 500 restaurants, making it the largest American barbecue chain in the world. Dickey's has suffered some of the effects of any restaurant that grows to this size, however, with the most notable one being that the food can fall under par. For example, one reviewer reported that the mac and cheese tasted eerily like Stouffer's, and generally reported that the meats were not bad. The verdict? If you live in an area that isn't known for its barbecue, and local restaurants aren't an option, Dickey's Barbecue Pit should still be your last resort. Dinosaur Bar-B-Que doesn't have nearly the number of restaurants as most of the other large barbecue chains out there. Instead, the company has just 6 locations, all of which are in New York. If you're thinking that New York doesn't have its own barbecue style, well, you're correct. Dinosaur Bar-B-Que actually specializes in St. Louis-style ribs, which are dry-rubbed and slow-smoked, although it does offer a number of other options too, each coming from a different regional tradition. With fewer locations than its rivals, Dinosaur Bar-B-Que is able to offer a better experience than some of the bigger chains. But without a single style tying everything together, the menu feels a little random and disconnected. And some reviewers report that while the meat itself isn't bad for an East Coast restaurant, the dishes are practically drowned in sauce. Most authentic barbecue restaurants let diners sauce the meat themselves rather than doing so in the kitchen, which is arguably Dinosaur Bar-B-Que's biggest mistake. Another chain founded in a city that isn't known for its barbecue, City Bar-B-Que got its start in Upper Arlington, Ohio, near the state's capital. It's also newer than most of the barbecue chain restaurants ranked on this list, having been launched in 1999 by founder and current owner Rick Mailer.
It lasted about a day until I told my wife Bonnie, and then it became We very quickly, and now we have over 1,000 teammates of We.
Today, the chain has locations in 7 states. While it might not be a top choice for proper barbecue lovers, it has succeeded in bringing barbecue to areas where the style is less common. One thing in particular that makes City Bar-B-Que stand out from the big names is that they often run out of certain meats partway through the day. If this sounds like a bad thing, you'll think otherwise when you hear the company's explanation. According to Mailer, "We're proud of the fact that we don't reheat food and only serve fresh products. When we sell out, and we need to let the guests know that because sometimes it's going to happen." If you've never visited Hawaii, you might not know that the state has its own unique style of barbecue. L&L Hawaiian BBQ was first launched in the Aloha State, and for over 50 years, it has served fresh lunches throughout the islands. Today, the brand has expanded to more than 200 locations in the lower 48. L&L Hawaiian BBQ is known for serving up authentic Hawaiian-style barbecue. This means plates with a double serving of white rice, macaroni salad, a sampling of fresh-caught seafood, chicken, and other proteins, which are grilled rather than smoked. This unique style of barbecue is the result of 19th-century sugar plantation laborers who came to Hawaii from all over the world in search of work, sharing their lunches in the process. This, in turn, led to the development of a blend of regional cuisines, hence the white rice alongside macaroni salad and grilled meats. While ribs and brisket aren't on the menu here, a variety of other options will be, ones that are arguably more interesting than anything you'll find in a standard barbecue joint. Corky's Ribs and Barbeque has its roots in real Memphis-style barbecue. The first Corky's opened in Memphis, Tennessee in 1984. The restaurant is far from a copy of authentic Memphis-style barbecue, too. In fact, it's one of the restaurants that pioneered it. Despite having expanded beyond Memphis and even beyond Tennessee, the restaurant remains popular among locals. In fact, it's been voted the number one barbecue joint in the city a whopping 22 times. Its Memphis-style barbecue starts with a spice rub, which often has a unique blend of herbs and spices created by each restaurant's pitmaster. Next, sauce is added to the various types of meat as it is smoked. The result is added flavor and a caramelized finish. Today, Corky's Ribs and Barbecue locations keep things classic with Memphis-style brisket, pork, ribs, and sausage. According to reviewers, however, some Corky's locations can be a little better than others. For example, one reviewer called the chain's Gatlinburg, Tennessee location the worst barbecue place I have ever been. In Memphis, barbecue meats are sauced, then smoked. But in St. Louis, that order is flipped. St. Louis is known for its ribs in particular, which are grilled rather than slow-smoked, then sauced heavily in the city's classic style of sauce, which is sweet and a little acidic. But while ribs might be the star of the show, other meats get the same treatment in the gateway to the West. St. Louis has plenty of barbecue restaurants to choose from, of course. One of the most popular chains, however, is Sugarfire Smokehouse. The company was started by Mike Johnson, a restaurateur and chef who was already running several successful restaurants across the city. When he heard that a local Dickey's was going out of business, Johnson stepped in with his own unique take on St. Louis barbecue and found immediate success. Today, Sugarfire Smokehouse has several locations across the country. The chain wins major points for its take on its home city's ribs and its unique sides, though other restaurants might be a better choice for other kinds of smoked meat. Full Moon Barbecue was founded in 1986 in the heart of Birmingham, Alabama. If you're eager to visit the original location, keep in mind that it follows tradition in more ways than one. And like most old-school barbecue stands, it's only open on weekdays and is closed on weekends. However, if you're looking to get your barbecue fix at any other time, you can visit one of their other 16 locations. While many barbecue chains have switched to smokers, Full Moon Barbecue keeps things classic. Each of the restaurant's locations has a 30-foot by 15-foot brick fire pit where they smoke their meats daily. Brisket, pork, chicken, turkey, and catfish are some of the menu's popular proteins, while traditional Southern trimmings are also available, including corn on the cob, collard greens, and deviled eggs. But while Full Moon's menu shines in some areas, it's a little lacking in others, and some reviewers have reported their meals being a little hit and miss. After visiting one of Mission Barbecue's locations, you won't be surprised to learn that the chain was opened on September 11, 2011, in an effort to change the world in one small way 10 years after the events of 9/11. Originally founded in Baltimore, this barbecue chain goes above and beyond in honoring veterans of the U.S. military, as well as firemen, police, and other first responders. The decor of each of their restaurants feature vintage photographs of military men and women, as well as hundreds of police, fire, and military badges, uniforms, and other memorabilia, much of which is provided by the chain's patrons. Every day at noon, the restaurant's staff also pause and stand to play the national anthem. For the land of the land of the free. As for the food, rather than focusing on a single barbecue style, the menu features a selection of different regional specialties, and you can dig into Texas-inspired brisket, St. Louis-style ribs, or Memphis-marinated meats. And it's pretty good, too. Nashville, Tennessee might not be as well known for barbecue as its western neighbor, but you wouldn't know that from the lines that wrap around the block at Martin's Barbecue's downtown Nashville location. Still, while Nashville might not have its own unique barbecue style, West Tennessee does. Rather than a style of rub or sauce, though, whole hog barbecue is the tradition on this side of the state. Whole hog roasts were once a staple in the region, but it's a dying tradition, thanks in part to rising meat costs and the time it takes to properly smoke a whole pig. Martin's Barbecue is perhaps the best-known place to still do it. Of the 30-ish barbecue joints across the U.S. that continue to roast whole hogs, six of them are Martin's locations. While not all Martin's Barbecue joints offer whole hog roasts, those that do roast on-site over coals and hickory chips. So if you're looking for delicious, authentic barbecue or a whole hog experience, Martin's is a must-visit on your next trip to Nashville. In 1990, Jeff and Joy Steeney attended their first barbecue contest, and they were instantly hooked. Not long after, they bought a competition-style smoker and started their own team, naming it Slaughterhouse 5. The team quickly started winning some of the most prestigious barbecue competitions in the country. It wasn't long before friends and acquaintances were begging the pair to open a restaurant. They resisted for several years before finally giving in early in 1996. Their first restaurant was actually called Oklahoma Joe's and opened in Stillwater, Oklahoma. Then, when the chicken counter in a gas station and convenience store closed in their neighborhood, they jumped at the opportunity to open a barbecue joint closer to home. They named it Joe's Kansas City Barbecue, and the rest, as they say, is history. The original location still exists, but has since taken over the entire building. Despite having plenty of competition, Joe's continues to be one of the most popular barbecue joints in Kansas City. If you want to experience authentic Kansas City barbecue at its finest, Joe's is always a great choice. Founder John Rivers launched Four Rivers Smokehouse in 2009 with one simple goal: to serve delicious, deregionalized barbecue. His restaurant is a passion project that he only launched after leaving behind a successful 20-year career as the president of a billion-dollar healthcare company. The restaurant actually got its start in 2004 after Rivers launched the Barbecue Ministry, a fundraiser cookout he hosted to raise money for a family with a young daughter diagnosed with cancer. It took a few years, but this garage operation inspired him to open a store. A line formed out the door of that restaurant on the first day and has returned nearly every day since then. The chain has since expanded across Florida. In particular, Four Rivers Smokehouse prides itself on delivering its own delicious take on each and every dish. This effort shows, too. The restaurant is popular among locals and visitors alike. As one reviewer put it, "Who doesn't love Four Rivers?" Check out one of our newest videos right here! Plus, even more mashed videos about your favorite foods are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.